What's up, everybody? If you want to take your Madden 22 game into the next level, the link in the description has my ebooks, and every ebook that you get gets a free upgrade for 4 months. I repeat, free upgrades for 4 months. Let's get it. In today's Madden 22 video, we're going to be going over the most explosive offense to use, the best offense hands down. Drop a like on the video if you enjoy this content, and I will keep pumping it out every single day. We are in the Seattle Seahawks offensive playbook. The reason why: winter time is coming up. There's going to be more time in the house to play the game, and if you play the game, you might as well play to win. So gun bunch, trips tight end, bunch tight end, and then you have the smaller packages. Now we're going to go over an easy mini scheme that you can use to be successful right away. It don't matter your level. So your audibles for this video is spacing, verticals, and flood. Then we got the halfback base in there, or you also can run the read option. So the first play we're going to do, we're going to come out in our vertical. So we're going to come out, we're going to pick a play, and we're going to do random defense. So we're going to look at the alignment. We're going to go to verticals. You're going to always flip the play. This is what separates mediocre players from great players. So come out, short side, flip the play. We looking to see if a person flips the play with you, if a cornerback or something travels with you to give you that tell on match coverage or man coverage, okay? So this motion out is crucial. We're gonna do this with two different plays. So what I like to do on this play, RB is your main route. X is a quick hitter. You can also let the running back come out of the backfield, and you can also ID the farthest cornerback to pick up any kind of blitz or pressure. So if you think the blitz is coming off the right side, ID the cornerback over there so number 78 will slide out as far as possible. Right now, I'm telling number 76 to slide out as far as possible. So we're going to look at X first to see if we get that quick read, and then the running back is going to be 90% completion every single time. It's hard to stop the running back. So we're gonna hike the ball right here, and you can see you can throw that super fast. If that guy starts backpedaling, you have that window. Even with Acrobat, they can't dive out there and get it. And that's gonna also let your quarterback get in the zone super, super fast. Now, the reason for this offense and what makes it so important is it's gonna force your opponent not to play the top tier defense. What's the top tier defense? Blitzing heavy or playing coverage and dropping your zone flats back deep. You don't want no 20s and 25 yard flats on the field. Now, when you come out and you are getting 2 and 3 yards, that's when you're gonna set up with hurry up offense to keep his zone adjustments at where they is. So you start the game off hitting him like this, he can't make them crucial adjustments. If you hurry it up and you follow my Patreon and my ebooks, you will have deep bombs on the right side, the left side, and down the middle, even with deep halves on the field, cover 4, cover 2, cover 3, all that will be broken down in the ebooks and on the Patreon. So right now we're trying to keep him at 10 flat and up, okay? So right here, as soon as he goes out and this guy backpedals, I can lead it to the outside. Boom, lead it to the outside, possession catch, easy dot. So right here, we started on around the 30. We're gonna turn up the field. He's backpedaling, that guy shoots out there, he can't get to it, down to about a 10, 11 yard gain. So we go to verticals, flip the play, motion him out right here, okay? So you're gonna have the X, then you're gonna look for the running back, and then you're gonna have the RB route down the seams. So here we go, he follows a man on man. You always got this running back out the backfield. It don't matter who your running back is, you have a good chance at getting separation unless they use it. So we're gonna go to verticals, we're gonna flip the play, and then put the running back in a quick out route, or if you have apprentice, you can put them in another route like this, the beat man, a lot of man routes, okay? So we're gonna come out here, they're giving us a man on man look again, but it can be a disguise. We're gonna look at X first, then we're gonna go to the running back. If that's covered, we do have that RB. Those are your three main reads. Every offense needs hot reads, okay? So we're gonna come right here, and he's back there again. We can throw that. This time we can catch and run 10, 12, 13 yards. Why is that important? Because your opponent can't put deep zones on the field. Now, when you pick a play, When your opponent starts taking more time to pick his play, you need to pay attention to his tendencies, okay? If he takes longer to pick his play, he's messing with his zone adjustments. That's when we come into spacing and all the different types of plays. So we're gonna go to spacing, okay? So here we go. We're gonna put our Y in the out route. We always want that running back combo. Now for spacing, we're gonna put our B and we're gonna go ahead and streak him down the field like this. And then we're gonna put our RB in a slant. If it's man coverage, it's gonna be double slant. So you got a high low read on both sides of the field. So we're gonna hike the ball right here. And then it's actually man coverage. And right there is a money dot. If we can get the blocks, we can turn that into an easy one play touchdown. Very simple, nothing crazy. Make your reads. We're gonna look at this play again. We go into spacing. We've been hitting the outsides, so they're gonna try to put cover two on the field, and that's what you want. So, cover two or anything like that. So we're gonna hike the ball right here. Our quick read, you can see the running back, he does have space right there. So we're gonna zoom in right here. So we're gonna look for the tight end first. He drops on him aggressive. Now, tight end, running back, and then one of these routes across the middle. Which one would a user pick up? He can't guard both of them. So if the user starts running with that route, the other route might go streak down the field, or he's gonna come back right here for a wide open dot. So tight end, boom, we can hit that. You see he get off the line of scrimmage, we can hit that real fast. 9 to 10 yard pickup. If y'all enjoy the content, don't be a hater. Drop a like on the video. Very easy scheme, but very important. So now I'm about to show you a simple trick that you can do with a play like verticals to be able to get Mike Evans with deep out elite open 80% of the time. Okay, so we're gonna go like this. We're gonna ID way over here, block the running back, bring him out, or you can put him into an out route. It don't really matter. Okay, you can do anything with the tight end, you can do anything with the B, but we're looking for the X receiver on this. So we're gonna hike the ball right here. And you see how we come back to the ball. We come back to the ball. He's past the 20 yards with deep out elite. Your opponent is not going to be able to stop that. So we're going to look at Mike Evans right here. So, boom. That guy is playing over the top. If they play over the top and you get at least 20 yards down the field with deep out elite, this is an instant catch every time. I come back and I strafe. Okay? So I know how I'm pass leading. I'm reading him. Is he to the outside? Is he to the inside? That's gonna help me determine my pass lead. I click on and strafe, that's L2, and then I aggressive catch. He will light up as long as he's outside the numbers. So we're gonna do that again. We're gonna go to like verticals, and then we're gonna ID him over here. Delay block, it don't really matter. We're gonna bring him out. They thinking it's the same play, and we are taking a deep shot down the field. So we're gonna hike the ball. Boom, we can come back, catch it. You see he lights up right there at the end zone. Now, it don't matter how far away that you are, you can get that every single time. That comes in handy with deep out elite because your opponent is not gonna be able to interact. He's running around with a user super fast, looking for somebody else, and when you throw that ball and he clicks on, he's gonna be out of place. So, we go, we're gonna push, boom. Click on, I stay in front of him. Big body receiver, deep out elite, he can't make that. Only thing he can do is try to hold the SWAT and know that it's coming, okay? So here come the ball, I click on, the computer can't adjust fast enough. We're gonna do it again, one more time. Now I'm in the zone. So now I'm in the zone with double me that fast. So we're gonna make sure that we pick up the blitz. We're gonna bring him out that same type of way. We're gonna actually just slant our tight end this time, and we're gonna see what kind of coverage we got. So here we go. Boom, I come back, and look at that. Easy, easy touchdown. Drop a like on the video if y'all want more in-depth schemes, and if y'all want the full ebook, or become a Patreon member just to show your support, we in the zone.